back with me from Orthocell. I'm joined by Paul Anderson. Paul, nice to see you.
Ah, thanks for having me, Andrew.
Paul, uncertain times at the moment. I wanted to get a question to you on COVID. How's some of the recent challenges affected your business?
Yeah, no, excellent question. Obviously, there's been some challenges both professionally and personally to all of us during this time. And particularly in the medical manufacturing business, we've had to look at and risk assess all of the impacts, potential and real, on our business. And then we've had to, of course, from that assessment, manage some of those risks. Of course, we have had numbers of staff working from home. We've had more of a skeleton crew around our manufacturing here, being able to maintain our operations, yet respect all of the COVID restrictions that we've had. Obviously, there's been some impact from a business perspective with elective surgeries being closed down or temporarily suspended. That's had a small impact on some of our clinical trials. But I'm delighted to say that those elective surgeries are now getting up and running here in Australia. And so we're back on deck with the clinical delivery of our technologies. But importantly, many of the activities and our major milestones in the company today are based around, our regulatory applications globally. And so, of course, we've been able to galvanise the team, maintain our productivity. And in actual fact, I think it's been a great opportunity to improve our connectivity and our communication.
So you've submitted the 510K for CelGro Dental?
Yeah, very exciting milestone for our company. This is the first application of our CelGro technology for guided bone regeneration and soft tissue reconstruction. And that's obviously into the world's largest healthcare market. So we're excited about that application and submission, and we're very much looking forward to the day that that's approved.
So what are, Paul, just remind us, what are potentially the next steps as far as the dental program?
Yeah, so we currently have our first product to market for CelGro has been approved in the EU for guided bone regeneration and soft tissue reconstruction. We continue to drive that business in those jurisdictions, attracting global key opinion leaders, centres of excellence, and really recruiting new patients and clinics on board. And the next phase for us now is this submission into the US. And so advance of that approval coming through to the US, we are now starting to build our key opinion leader network in the US in a geographical sense, so that we're very highly focused, that we've got the right people on board, and that we're going to moving towards a product launch preparation as of today, effectively.
What's happening, Paul, as far as your nerve program?
Yeah, look, it's an excellent question, and I'm pleased you asked. This is probably one of the most exciting aspects of our company today. We have developed a collagen-based medical device called CelGro. CelGro has a multitude of different applications. It's a platform technology that we can manufacture in different sizes, shapes, and thicknesses, depending on the tissue need. So we've just spoken about our indications for bone regeneration and soft tissue reconstruction. Very large market, $1 billion market, very exciting. But what we've also discovered in the journey of development with this product is that we are now using CelGro in a much smaller and thinner incarnation to join severed and crushed nerves back together again. So we've been able to use our CelGro to affect a sutureless and tensionless repair of damaged nerve tissue. And effectively, what we've been able to show in the early clinical data that we recently announced to the market, that we're able to restore function back to paralyzed limbs, including quadriplegic and tetraplegic patients, in a more predictable and a faster way than anything else that's available in the market today. So we recently interviewed one of our patients who's a quadriplegic, and he said, Paul, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for what you've done for me. And I said, oh, well, you know, that's, I'm delighted. And he said, no, I want to thank you because I can now hug my children. I can now drive a car. I can now lift up my telephone. I can now play basketball. So these are life-changing moments that we've been able to play a really important part of. And we're extremely excited. And as a consequence of that, we are now accelerating the development regulatory-wise of our collagen medical device. We're preparing for a submission into the Australian regulatory TGA, and we're also preparing for an EU submission, with, of course, the main prize being an application into the US market for our nerve indication also.
Well, certainly busy times, Paul. You're active on a number of fronts here.
Yeah, you're absolutely correct, and this is a busy time. But what's important to note is that the regenerative medicine concepts that we are applying to both bone, nerve, and to tendon tissue are essentially the same. So the skill sets required, the learnings that we have, the product that we've manufactured has similar interactions across those tissue types. So yes, busy, exciting program, but really focused on driving our key products through into the market.
Have you got is it a collaboration with Johnson & Johnson?
Yes, we do. Johnson & Johnson has sponsored a clinical study that we are conducting here in Australia. We're conducting that in Melbourne, Sydney and Perth. And that study is really centered around one of the other products that we have in the company called Ortho-ATI. That is a cellular therapy for the regeneration of damaged and degenerate tendon tissue. And so that's a very exciting product that we have in the company, one that is nearing the end of that clinical study, sponsored by Johnson & Johnson. And we're very excited about what that's going to bring from a results perspective, and then potentially what that may bring from a relationship perspective also.
And your clinician advocacy program, that's making some good progress, is it?
Look, it's very, very important that there's a number of areas here that really attract the key partners in these markets. There's a number of pieces that enable you to get traction in these markets. Having a good product is one piece. But you really have to have some extremely good market entry plans that revolve around very high quality education, that evolve around value adding to the key surgeons in the globe today. And so we've engaged with clinicians that we describe as key opinion leaders. They are brand advocates, they educate other surgeons, and they are the early adopters that assess the quality of these technologies. And then they go and promote these technologies, not because we pay them, not because, you know, of anything else other than this is a really, really exciting set of technologies that are changing people's lives. And so key opinion leaders want to be a part of that exciting pathway.
Well, a final thought then for us, Paul, you've got a number of important milestones coming up, and significantly, you've got a good cash balance to see you through.
Yeah, look, I think it's an important note to finish on. I think, and I'm old enough to have lived through 87 crash, the GFC, the Asian turndown, you know, and one thing that we've consistently seen is that companies that are well-funded in particular, and we have a good two-year runway to achieve the milestones that we've articulated to the market in our FDA approval, our TGA approval, continued march into these international markets. But what we've seen is that healthcare is a space in life sciences that resonates very, very well in these periods. So well-funded company, we have outstanding and very exciting technologies, and we have the ability to really punch out the other side of this COVID-19 impact, and that we're very comfortable and confident about.
Great to see you, Paul. Thanks very much.
It's my pleasure, Andrew, and thanks for your time. Bye-bye.